Hey guys, I don't say this until the end of the video, but thank you guys so much for all the views, all the likes, and even the dislikes, because I only got 6 dislikes, which is really good, so even thank you for that. And thank you for 67 comments, and thank you for the suggestions of editing apps to make my life easier. And yeah, I'm really thankful for that, and thank you guys so much for watching and subscribing, because I started off with 0 subscribers, now I have 59, which is really awesome. And once I hit 100, I'm gonna do 100 special, even though nobody watches my channel, or I bet no one has post notifications on. But yeah, if you guys do, then please watch, please like, please subscribe and stuff. And yeah, and I do have another channel. I will link that in my any videos in the description. I will link the stuff. So yes, let's move on to past Kylie, because this is future Kylie. So yeah, thank you guys so much. I love you all. And yeah, let's get on with me talking and doing the tutorial. Yeah, finally,
hey guys, it's Kylie, and today I'm here with the episode tutorial that all of you guys have really been waiting for.
By a lot of you guys, I mean 5 of you guys, because like, nobody really wanted to see a tutorial, but a lot of people were asking questions, so maybe they wanted to see a tutorial. So guys, I'm gonna do the book cover just like this one right here, but a little bit different. I'm gonna change it up a little bit. So this video is a tutorial. Last video was not a tutorial. So everybody was talking about when you're gonna make a tutorial. Well, not everybody, like one person kept asking questions about a tutorial, and I was like, okay, give me a chance, please. I just need to make the tutorial, because like, I haven't really made anything. And they were asking for a mobile tutorial, and I really didn't know how to do an episode cover on a phone. So I'm gonna try to figure that out, and yeah, so I might make a tutorial on that too. And yeah, I love episodes, guys. But yeah, if you guys want to see, if you guys want to know my episode stories, then when I upload them, because they're not uploaded yet, but when I upload them, I'll put it in the link in the description, and I'll update you guys on what my episode stories are like. And if you guys would like to watch them, you can go ahead and go watch them. And yeah, so isn't that great? Yeah, okay. So yeah, let's get on with the tutorial, because you know, this is what some of you guys have been waiting for, like 5 of you. Okay, let's go. Oh, okay. So guys, we're on the episodeinteractive.com, which is where you make the episode stories and stuff. You can see this cute little backdrop thingy magic. So you want to scroll down and you can see what is episode. So you got all these stories. Build your avatar, meet your famous stars, episode. And yeah, the new battle, Pretty Little Liars, all types of stuff. Make choices and stuff. Oh, sorry, excuse me. And make choices and stuff. Episode is really, really cool. But it's so much scripting you have to do, and it's like crazy. Some people go by the scripting like, it's like people, a lot of people finish their scripting like really fast. Or you can make, but I just learned that you can make stories on a phone a while ago. I learned, and I did not know you could do that until just a while ago. So, yes, you can do that. But, yeah, okay, so you just want to scroll all the way down on the page, and you want to sign in with Google or sign in with whatever you want to sign in with. So, I'm going to sign in with Google and create an account or whatever. And I'm sorry, guys, if it's too loud, because my mom's kind of on the phone. She's getting a little excited. I don't know why. But if my dad's in his man cave yelling, my sister's sleeping, but she's probably going to get up because all this noise. My baby sister's playing a Roblox game, and it's like really loud skateboarding or something. So, yeah. Okay, so after you sign in with Google or Facebook or make an account or whatever you do, then you want to have your story open. So you can go to whatever story your cover is going to be for. It doesn't, well, you can go to any story. It doesn't matter if it's your story, you just gotta grab a character from the story and go. So I'm gonna go to manage your stories, because, well, manage my stories. But I'm gonna go there and go to a different story, which is gonna be bad luck. So if you guys have seen my tutorial, I put the bad luck cover on there, and it was this, the ones that I uploaded. And yeah, so I am not gonna use this. I don't really like it that much. The outfit's ugly, first of all. And yeah, so I'm gonna change it
to make it look better. And it's going to be better, like great better, okay? So let's go back to bad luck. I haven't been working on this story in a long time, but hopefully, look, I have 3 of them. So hopefully I get to working on them and you guys can finally read my stories and stuff. Okay, so if you haven't already made your story and made your characters, go ahead and go to characters and you will see a big list of characters. Actually, no, you won't. You can click new character. And all you gotta do is you just gotta pick a name for your character. And then whatever you want it in your story, though, because it doesn't matter, but like what you want this character to be named in the story and stuff is however you want it. But you could just make up a new story and like put one little character in there and you can be done and not use that story. Either one you want to use. But yeah, and then you click which one to start with, but you can edit it later. So if you want to start with a partner, start with a partner. I don't know how to say their name. So you just find their name and then you create and save. So then you can edit it and stuff whenever you want. So we got all these people and stuff. This is me, actually. This is the author right here generating for you. Okay, so that's me as the author. And I come into the story every now and then and tell you guys thank you and stuff. So I'm gonna go to this character. So this is the character that I want. So let's go to outfits. And that outfit is really dusty. I really don't like that outfit. So I'm gonna change my character. Oh, I should have probably, hold on. This is just a starter character, so it's not really supposed to be nice. But, you know, it's just a starter. So, like, it's what you start with. And then I made the, gave you the choice to change your character if you want. So, yeah. So you can change your character whenever you want. And episode has updated with a couple of things, which is really great. So, yeah, got some new features to this. But whatever outfit you want to wear on your character is what you want to put on there. But I'm just going to leave it default, and I'm going to change the default outfit because the default outfit is not the best looking. I think the only thing I really need to change are the pants. The pants are what are really bothering me, so... So you can go to clothing types and filters and stuff. So you can click bottoms. So after you do all that, now, oh my gosh, I need to hurry. I already been recording for 11 minutes. Okay. So now you can go back and now you can continue to whatever episode you are on. You can go to any episode that you have published or did anything with. You can do whatever you want. This episode I haven't even started on, which is pretty sad. But okay, so we got... This is the character I just edited. My mouse is like stupid. But once you push the plus on your character that you just edited and stuff, you have these little thingies to do. So you can do, let's apply lipstick. So there's so many things you can do. Idle is like when you just sit there and do something. Like you don't have to be sitting, but yeah. Like this smoking one, you'll see it's just like that. Yeah. So, but if you do things like laugh, like there's emotions, it's like listen underscore phone underscore angry or listen underscore phone underscore eye roll. So it's like it's things to put in your story. So while you're talking, you do certain actions and stuff. So it's really cool. So I'm going to do idle underscore cross arms or something. You have to really think. Like if you got something, like if you want to put something on there, you got to think about what the name of it would be. Like it could be talk underscore cross arms. So, like, arms crossed, yeah. Or idle underscore arms crossed. Hopefully there's one on there. Yeah, but you got to think about what it could be and what, like, where to find it and stuff. So maybe it's arms crossed. Yeah, arms crossed angry. So you just sit there, arms crossed angry, yeah. So right when she's doing the moment, right when you want... your character to be, like, if your character's moving around a lot, then if you want to add, like, the perfect moment, then what you gotta do is you gotta, like, push, save image as at the right time, okay? All you really gotta do. So, I'm gonna go to episode, characters for episode, bad luck. Okay. There we go. So, we got that down. So now you want to make sure I should have had you do this before, but you want to go to getpaint.net,
Oh wait, get paint.net. I already said that. It's because the app is called paint.net, so I thought it was get paint.net. So you push get it now. And this is only for Windows, okay? You cannot do this on Mac because Mac cannot download .pda and stuff. That's why I like Windows better, because you can get download so many more editors and stuff that really help you. Because a lot of them don't have Apple versions to them. So, yeah. So make sure you get the free one. Do not pay for this one. So you push that one, and then you push free download now, and then this will be here. So once it's downloading, you want to click on it, and then it should set up everything for you. But I recommend, if you're watching this tutorial through without doing it at the same time, then I will recommend that you download paint.net while you are editing your character and all that stuff, so it can be done while you're doing something else. So, yeah. So now, wait, first I'm gonna go to Google and search episode covers, and we're gonna come over here, and you gotta see like the covers, not like just these random ones. So we got these. So a lot of people are really unique with their stuff, like this one, and a lot of people, you can edit your character a lot if you wanted to, but you don't have to. There's stuff like this. So these are the sizes for the thingy that you need. So you need 966 by 642, and you need 420 by 58. So make sure you remember those, or mark it down or something, or just go back to it when you need to. But so 966 by 642. The other one was 420 by 480, so we're just gonna do 420 by 580. Sorry, I did that last time too. But I'm gonna exit out all this Roblox stuff because this is not Roblox time. Okay, now we only have these things. So you gotta think of a type of background that you want. So if your story is sad like mine, you wanna get like Tumblr thingies. So you wanna go to, I'm gonna do rain, black, and white Tumblr. Always add Tumblr to it. Okay, so we got stuff like this. So mine is a sad story. So make sure you just want whatever your story is kind of based on. You can do that as a background. Or you could just put a color. You add those on your story if you want to. Or if you don't, then that's fine. Okay, so now that we've done that, we can now go to We can now go to our thingy-majig. Let's open the image of the Roblox. Bad luck. Episode D. Okay, so we got, let's open up this one and this one. Okay, so sometimes there's some things that happen to you. If you get the outline of your character, it always messes up. Like 99.9% of the time, it will be a bad outline because of the colors that it's matching to the background. So that's why I highlight my character. Or if you don't want your character to be like glowing, kind of, then just take an eraser and go around the whole body. Have fun doing that. All you have to do to add an outline is you take the magic eraser again and click on the back. And now what you want to do is you want to make sure you add a new layer, okay? Don't forget to do that. Now you click rectangle select and you push control and you right click. You just drag it. And then you make sure you're on the other layer, not the background. You're on this layer. Make sure you're on there. Whatever you want your outline to be of your character, black or white or pink and blue, whatever you want, just fill the bucket. So now what you do is you switch these. Then you put the other one at the bottom. So now what you want to do is you go to effects and push blurs and then Gaussian blur. So every time the outline of my character is white, see, you can see it right there. But you know, it's so irritating how it does this every single time. Like, there's never a time where it doesn't do that. So you just want to make the radius go up a little bit. And then what you want to do is you duplicate this layer a bunch of times, however you want it. But the more I duplicate it, the more it shows the dusty background of the character. So I'd rather just leave it like this. But now you got this image. It's pretty tiny, so hopefully when you make it bigger, it doesn't like get all Greeny. Yeah, I knew it was gonna be that. Grainy, I mean. I didn't mean greeny, I mean grainy. Okay. Greeny is like the what's his name? Thomas from Maze Runner. But okay, so now let's get some more stuff aside to the background. Let's just open it up now. And we can blur it, and it's really big, so it should be able to fill up everything. Okay, so we just copy that, and then we put it over here, canvas side, and yeah, I like it. Okay, that's great. So now let's paste in the other one, and now let's blur both of them just a little tiny bit. I don't want to blur them too much like that, no. But if I'm gonna blur it like three. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this little thingy right here, the shape thingy, and I'm gonna surround it with white, like not. Oh yeah, sorry guys. Okay, for the you gotta make sure you make a new layer and then do this. Okay, okay, make a new layer and then do it, because you might want your character to go behind or in front of it. You want it to go in front, then it doesn't matter. So we got both of these now again. So now all we gotta do is we gotta get our mad little character, or however your character is feeling. We gotta add a new layer. Make sure you do that. And then put your character in. Oh, wait. Sorry, guys. Okay, first, before you take your character, make sure you merge the layers down. So make sure you go to the first layer and then push merge layer down. Okay? Just like that. And then you copy. And then you paste it on. Wait, not right here yet. Or you can add a new layer, and then you paste it. And make sure you get it to be a nice size, because you don't want it. So make sure you shape your character out. And I'm going to put the feet behind it. And I'll move the character. Oops. Move her a little bit over. Like right in the middle. It looks really bad. So what I'm going to do actually is I'm going to delete this layer and then redo this part right here and make it white, because it's always, every time there's a white outline, so I might as well just make it white. And then now you can copy and paste it again and put it over where you want it. See, now you can't tell it's like dusty. So if I put this on top, I like the way that looks on top. I'll just leave it like that. So now you do that to the other one, and I think we're good to go. Oh, that's why the outfit looked ugly. She got denim on denim. That's pretty ugly. Sorry guys, I'm sorry. Like, if I was making a story, I would really be trying to make this look good, but like, I feel like I'm really not trying. Okay, so if you guys want to add some cool emojis to it, then do that. And if you want to add the episode logo to it, then do that. You know, but let's just take the magic eraser and delete and click and stuff, and then let's just put that in on these places. So add a new layer always. There we go. So now that we have that, we're gonna add the emojis now. So I have a whole folder for emojis and stuff. So let's, okay, so All you want to do is copy one of them. Make sure you always add a new layer. That's our number one rule of paint.net. Corner. And now we're going to take this one. We're just going to cut that out. And we're going to put it in there. Down. So let's move on. So let's just save these as, and make sure it's PNG or you can't use it. So you can put a gibberish if you want. Make sure you always flatten it, because if you don't, then it won't save. So make sure you put PNG. Okay, and flatten. So now we're just gonna go to a website called PhotoJet. All these links that I have are gonna be all in the description. So yeah, so calm down guys. If you want to make an account for this, then you can. That's perfectly fine. So all you want to do is click edit a photo. And this is like PicMonkey, but better than PicMonkey. Let's open and push computer or Facebook, whichever one you want to use. So you want to go to the episode thingy, and then you want to open up one at a time because you can't do both. So just open up one at a time. Okay, so we got this one right here. But I don't think these are that bad. I kind of like it though. So, but first let's name it Bad Luck. So we can change the fonts, and you have to have like a premium thingy to get certain fonts, but there's some really good fonts for these, so I don't really mind. And then you can go to effects, and you can change the opacity of it, and you can add an outline and a glow to it, and you can change the radius. So the color of the outline needs to be, I'm gonna make the color of the outline black, and then the text is gonna be gray. Yeah, that's nice. And then we're gonna add a little by Kylie McCleary. You can move these to make it like that or something, however you want it. So I'm gonna add another effect. Okay, so we got that together. But I'm gonna make it a little tiny. I don't want it too big because that's not the title of the thing. So. Okay, so that's good. So let's just save. And I'm gonna save it as 00000 and all these zeros. So when I first open it up in my notes, then it's the first thing I see because there's a bunch of zeros on it. Whatever. Now you wanna open the other one. There we go. And now all you have to do when you're done is upload these to. You gotta upload these to episodes. So now go to episode and go to your story. And now I think this one is better than my last one, maybe. Maybe. I like that one too. But okay, so if I choose a file picture, and if I wanna change, I can always change to the other one. So this one is the I have to go to this. And go to, can I move these? Oh, thank you. Okay, now that's the little one. I mean, it's not that little bit. Okay, so it says, you gotta make sure you click the box. And it says any images that haven't been published, pending approval, etc., will be overwritten. So, let's just continue because it's gonna overwrite my stuff, but you know, it's fine because I like this one a lot. Okay, so now let's add the other one, the bigger one. And let's click this box, save, and continue. Woo! Guys, we did it. We finished. Oh, we finished. Yay. We're done. How long have I been recording? 49 minutes. I've been recording 7 minutes longer than my last video that I recorded before. And I was trying to beat that record by doing it way before, but didn't work. But yeah, I feel like, yeah, this was a success, guys. And I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you did, please give it a thumbs up. And guys, again, thank you guys so much for 8,000 likes on the last video. 8,277 to be exact. 8,281 now to be exact. And 81 likes, 6 dislikes, but that's okay because that's not that many dislikes. And 6 dislikes, but you know, that's fine. But because it's not compared to the amount of likes that I have. And thank you for the 67 comments. I made a lot of those comments though to respond to people and stuff. A lot of people are suggesting things to me, and I'm really thankful for you guys suggesting all types of editing apps and stuff. That's so kind of you guys. I really am glad that you guys are giving me tips and giving me giving me apps that I can use to improve my editing and stuff. Thank you guys for that. Yeah, that's basically it for the video. Thank you guys so much for all those views. And thank you guys so much for watching this video. And I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. And I hope it helped you, like, a lot. And if it didn't, I'm sorry. And if it didn't, then I'll try to be better at tutorials. So, yeah. If you haven't already subscribed, please subscribe to this channel. And like my videos if you want. And share with your friends if you think this video deserve to be shared, and don't share with them if they're gonna make fun of them. So yeah. So yeah, I see you guys in my next video, which might be in a couple days, in like 2 days or something. Might upload something different. So yeah, see you guys in that video. Love you guys all. Love you guys. And what should my fan base name be? Like, I need a fan base name. So if you guys can comment down below any fan base names, then that'd be great. And yeah, love you guys. Bye.